Yes.
Yes. Can anyone tell me about birds?
Birds have feet and wings.
Yes, ma'am. Birds are the only animal that have feathers.
Okay.
They have wings and tail, but
Kind
also
animal.
fly.
Okay.
Okay.
Come on.
Then?
And they have two legs to move on land.
Tiny in color.
Okay. Okay. What else?
They have a beak to go
Okay.
and eat food.
Good,
What are
good, good.
the animals that
Fly easily.
The
Yeah,
body
that's
is a
fine.
divider.
Yeah, let's read this out and then know what are birds, okay? Can anyone read this out? Ritesh, can you?
Hello?
Rishitesh, I'm sorry. Rishitesh?
Yes, ma'am.
Read this out. Read this out loud.
Birds are the animals that can fly.
Tell, tell. Yeah,
Ma'am,
tell
in
me.
the assignment that you gave,
Yeah.
it 16th question, the
Okay.
the two statements and choose the correct option. The statement one was
Wait, wait, wait. Who is talking, by the way? Okay, Ishan. Okay, listen. Assignment regarding assignment, we'll keep it to the end of the class, okay?
Okay, ma'am.
You can ask me the doubts at the end of the class.
Okay.
Shall I read now?
Okay. So today's topic is birds. Yeah, I told Rishitesh to read this out.
Birds are the animals that can fly. They're
Yes.
divided into a head, trunk, and tail.
Okay. Then they have two pairs of limbs.
Pairs of limbs,
Huh.
the legs, and the wing.
Huh.
They have two legs but no hands. Their wings are covered with feathers. Their
The
mouth is
mouth
open with a
called
beak,
a
but
beak.
they don't have teeth at all. A
Huh.
bird can fly because it has a light body. It's a
Huh.
streamlined body and it has wings.
Good. Why do a bird can fly? Because there's something. Yeah, there are three points over here. Can you see my cursor?
Yes.
Yeah, tell me that. Read that out.
It has a light body.
It has a
Line body.
Has
It
wings.
has a streamlined body. It has wings, and that's why it can fly. So, in short, I'll tell you about birds. I'll read this out once again. Srihari. Srihari. Listen here. Yeah. Birds are the animals that can fly. First point. Second, how is the body of a bird divided? It is divided into head, trunk, and tail. They have two pairs of limbs. What do limbs do? Limbs are something which help them to move. Okay? So that is called limbs. So which helps them to move is the legs and the wings. Okay? They have two legs, but they have no hands. See, their wings are covered with feathers. And the mouth is called
Their mouth
beak.
is called a beak, but they
Beak.
don't have teeth at all.
Yes, and they do have tongue, right?
Birds can fly because
What is trunk?
it has a light body.
Yes.
Ha it
Now,
has
how can they fly?
a
I'll give you a
streamlined body.
It has wings.
It has wings.
Wait, wait.
Ma'am, you have written that birds even
I'll show you the bird's picture and then I'll tell you what this trunk actually means, okay?
have
See,
trunk. Where is
firstly, we have to know how do birds fly. To know how birds fly, we'll get we'll just read I'll read this out for you. Wait.
Their lungs are great at getting oxygen, are very efficient, so they all can fly for a very long distance
without getting tired. Okay, so the points I'll tell you. The points you need to listen. Students, listen. Listen once. Points you need to remember. But if someone asks you why, how do birds fly, you need to tell them that they first thing they have hollow bones. Okay, that are very light and strong. Okay, and the feathers are light and.
I'll tell you what hollow means.
See, listen. Can you see my hand?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
If yeah, give me a second. Yeah. If this is the bone, you find something empty inside, right?
Yeah,
this part is the bone, and you find something empty inside. This is the bone. Here, emptiness is called as hollow bone. So, such kind of bones are present in the bird's body. Okay, that is called hollow bones, and yeah, they're very light, right? And they were strong too. See, the feathers are light, and see, even when they fly, also, if just imagine, can you see my hand?
Yes.
Yeah,
ma'am.
This hand, you just think this as a feather. If they're flying, the air direction comes this way, and it gets into the feathers. It moves here, so they have tiny holes. They have space for the air to enter also. That doesn't stop air. See, suppose if the bird is flying this way. Give me a second. I'm so sorry. Yeah, if suppose the birds are flying, you might feel that if at all you try to, jump also, the air tries to stop you, right? But in birds' case, that doesn't happen. So if this is a feather, they have space. Feathers will be arranged in layer by layer. So they'll be having space. So whenever the air enters to that, the air comes out from the back. So in the opposite direction, when the air is always in the opposite direction of the bird. So that's how air goes to the feathers and come out from this other place. The another thing is their lungs are very great at getting oxygen and very efficient. Okay. So they can fly for long time and long distance without getting tired. I'm sorry. Yeah. Now let's go into this slide. What's body parts of a bird?
The body parts of the bird.
Yeah, you can see this picture.
Head or crown, beak, belly,
ears,
and
tail. The crown, wings, belly, claws, beak, eye.
Yeah. See,
eye, beak, belly, claws.
Listen to me. Yeah. So here you can. What all you can see? You can see eye. This is the eye of a bird. This part from here to here is called head or crown. The head part or crown. The next, this is belly.
The disturbance coming from me is actually from my little brother.
Okay, that's all right, Srihari. No problem. See, so this is the beak. Can you see my cursor?
Yes.
Yes.
This is the beak. This is head or crown. These are the wings, belly, claws. This one are the claws. This one is the tail. So, I think Rishitesh, you asked me where is the trunk?
Right? Yes.
This
belly. Oh, ma'am, I asked.
Who asked?
I asked.
Ishan.
I'm Ashan.
Ishan. Okay. Ishan. Ishan. Yeah, yeah. Okay, fine. So this belly, wings, and claws together give rise to trunk. Together, it is called as trunk.
What, ma'am?
This belly. You can see my cursor, right? Belly, yes. Wings, yes, and belly and wings together is termed as trunk.
Okay.
Okay. We'll get
okay, back to ma'am. This speech.
Okay.
Okay. Now you will be telling me. We'll just go into this thing. All common birds. Yes. You see many birds around you, right? In your surroundings.
Yes. Yes.
I'll just show you the pictures. You'll have to tell me which bird is that, and you have to tell me what it actually does. What you observe from it. Okay. Yes. Have you seen this bird?
The hummingbird.
Ma'am, I'm not seeing that. I don't see. Excuse me, ma'am. Hello.
Hello.
Hello, ma'am. Hello. Hello, ma'am. Hello.
Are you able to hear me?
Hello, yes. Ma'am.
Yes.
Hello, ma'am.
Yes, now I can see.
Ma'am.
Divya.
Yes.
Divya Bhandari, can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am, we can hear you.
Good, good. Now are you able to see the picture over here in the screen?
This is a crow.
Can anyone tell me? No, it's not crow. It's not crow. Can anyone tell me which picture?
Maina.
Maina.
Very good. Very good.
It's a maina only, but it's a common maina.
Yes. Now, this is the body explanation. I'll tell you. Vinous brown body, black head, and yellow orbital area. This part, this yellow orbital area, can you see?
I never heard about common myna.
You've never seen myna at all? Common myna, see, just because
I can see it in my place. Got
name as common myna.
Okay.
Okay.
Have it?
Yeah. So the habitat. Habitat is this thing is like where does it? Where is it seen most commonly? Okay, and where does it live? That is called as habitat. I'll tell you. Found around human habitation, open country, farmlands, cities, and hills up to 3,100 meters. Yeah. It can only fly up to that range only. It can. Above that, it can't. Okay?
Oh, this is...
We'll look at some other pictures. Second
one. What is... Which state...
Okay, give me a second.
...across the country? Range. Which state...
Widespread resistant across the country. Ma'am, what is range?
What is this?
There's some problem.
Okay, ma'am. Ma'am, please check that you send.
Are you able to see this?
Yes. Watch.
Yes.
Yes. Which bird is this?
Eagle.
Right.
Not eagle.
It's a black kite.
Black kite.
But it's not black, but belly is not white.
This is just a description about the bird. You don't need to, read it in depth or learn it in depth. That's okay, fine. It is almost fine everywhere, right? Black kite.
Yes. It is everywhere.
Yes. Commonest bird of prey that we get to see today. Circles in the sky for us, often seen in a track that roost near a preferred feeding area. Partial to
on earthworms. Nests and
feeding on earthworms. So what does it feed on? Earthworms. You know earthworms, right?
Nest in tall trees.
Yes.
Commonest bird.
It all.
that we see
earthworms,
circles in the sky for hours and often.
Next. Which word is this?
Pigeon. Croc pigeon.
Yeah.
Croc pigeon.
Large frogs attack their feeding areas, feed on seeds and shoots, much given to aggressive courtship. Ledges and
holes.
It's almost like an pigeon.
Yes.
Omnivores that eat flesh of other animals.
And?
Animals that eat flesh of other animals.
And? It also eats vegetarian food. That yes. Eats veg and non-veg both.
Like beer and monkey.
And what is gregarious means?
Bare boning is true.
And what is gregarious means?
And is well.
I'm not getting
it. I'm touched by the issue. Man, what is means of opportunist? Six.
Opportunistic behavior. Basically, it means like. How do I tell? Opportunistic feeder. What does it mean? Opportunistic feeder. It's like how you know that feeds on something. How do I tell this? Bold, smart, and ready. Objective.
Even non-veg and even veg.
I'll give you an example. Wait. Give me a second.
Okay. Please give me a. Now that I understand,
Soham
is saying, Soham is saying, mom.
Wait. Give me a second. See, opportunistic feed is an animal that is a generalist when it comes to eating. Okay, opportunistic feeder means it eats many kinds of prey. Like it does not only feed on one particular thing. I'll tell you this lion is there, okay? See, for lion, we can't see lion does not.
Ma'am, it is saying that you have paused screen sharing.
Called a house crow because it feeds things which people in houses eat.
Give me a second, 1 second, students. Wait, I'll give you listen everyone to me. I'll give you an example of opportunistic, I'll tell you. See, lion, okay. You all know lion, right?
Yes, ma'am. King of forest.
Lion feeds only on non-veg. I mean, flush meat and all those things. Okay. But crow doesn't feed only on flush, or it doesn't only feed on this veg. Rice, grains, and all those things. See, opportunistic means it feeds on all varieties of food, kind of thing. Okay. Yeah.
Like an omnivore.
Yeah, it's an omnivore also. I'll say, though breeding pairs roost together, its interdependent pair bonding is strong. Okay, wait. Okay, this is done. So, let's go into the classification of birds. Birds are classified into the classification. Hello. Are Are you able to hear me?
Ma'am, Soham is chatting too much.
I'll tell him. Soham, don't do that, Soham.
Excuse me, ma'am. I have a question.
Listen, everyone needs to listen to me, right?
Ma'am, he is saying.
I'll give you time to talk. That time you need to just tell me what are your doubts. Okay? For as of now, you'll listen to me. Now, we'll just look into classification of birds. Birds are classified into features, sound they make, migration, nest. Now, under that, we have many types. Let's come into features only. Body. By features, they are classified into in features like body, wings, beak, feet. And in wings, there are other classification like feather types. In beak, there are different types. And feet, there are different types. Understood? This is how birds are classified into. If anyone is having doubt, please tell me. Any doubt till now?
Yes, Soham has a doubt.
Yeah, Soham, tell me.
What is migration?
What is migration? We'll come to know. In this PPT, I'll be telling you about what on which basic features, sound, which and all types of sound they make, how are they classified, what is migration, how are they classified under migration, and nest. Based on this, I'll be telling you what it means, and I'll be giving you examples. Okay, is that fine?
Yes,
ma'am. Yeah. Now let's go into this.
What is adaptive and house crow? Does very smart and adaptive.
Who's talking? Something I'm not able to hear you. Can you please chat? If you have any doubt, please tell me.
Somebody again gave our link.
Put your doubts in the chat box. For as of now, I'll see the chat box. I'll text you. I mean, I'll clear your doubts at the end of the session. Okay.
Ma'am, that is
based on wings and feathers of birds. How are they classified? Ma'am. Let's see. You know the wings, right? Are you able to see the picture?
Feathers, wings and feathers.
Yes.
Ma'am,
wings. Birds have wings of different shape. First point, different size and color. Okay, wings help birds to fly. Three kinds of feathers found on birds' body. First is down feathers body, feathers flight, and feathers. Okay, these are the three kinds.
Wings and
feathers. Yes, let's go into feathers in depth. Are you able to see this, Luck?
Down feathers are soft and short.
Lie next to birds' body. Help to keep birds' body warm. Oh, there's a mistake over here. Okay, I'll.
This is a blue jay. I think that's
body. Body feathers give shape to birds' body. Cover the whole body.
The house crow is called a house crow because it eats the things that even what humans eat at home.
Yeah.
Like meat, fresh and all. Non-vegetarians bring and eat. The house crow also takes things like that and eats. Like that it does. That's why it's called a house crow.
Yeah, good.
Vegetable or a meat like.
Okay. Yeah, now let's go into this.
Unvegetable, that's all.
Flight feathers are the wings and tails. So any feathers that are found on the wings are called flight feathers. And that are on wings and tails, okay? What do these feathers help in? They help them to fly. Help to fly, to change direction.
And this is eagle. Ma'am, this is eagle.
This one is eagle, yeah.
Ma'am?
Mm-hmm.
And what is a king of birds?
What?
And what is king of birds?
Who is king of birds?
I didn't get you.
Fisher.
Mammy is saying who is king of birds? I think
it's eagle only.
Eagle is a king.
No.
Is there something like that? I don't know. I am hearing it for the first time. King of birds.
I also think that.
Yeah, golden eagle. Golden eagle.
Golden eagle. Wow.
No, happy eagle, ma'am. Yeah, right. Happy eagle.
Golden happy eagle is called a king of birds. Okay. Yeah, let's go to second. Beak.
Beak.
Can you see this picture?
Yes.
This thing, which is over here, this is called as beak. Okay, just like how we have mouth, birds have beaks.
I'm ready to ask anything.
Yeah, I'll tell you. What?
Ritesh, ask anything. Ritesh, ask anything.
Rishitesh?
Asking anything.
What is it? What are you asking, Rishitesh? Yes. Tell me.
What is adaptive? In the house, children, smart and adaptive.
What is adaptive?
Yes.
Adaptive is something which, how do I give you an example? See, suppose you live in your house, okay? Like, since you live in your house, you'll get adaptive to that. You'll get used to all those things, like how your culture and your, how your mom, dad and all, you have a particular culture and you get used to it. That culture you will get adaptive to that culture. That is called adaptation. And now even birds also, see, since they are birds, see, few polar bears, right? Polar bears, you know. They live in polar regions, right? Since they live in polar region, they'll have a very thick fur on their body, right? They have very thick since they live there, they adapted their body to, because their surroundings will they themselves change their body kind of things, they get adapted to that region, and then they'll have some changes in their bodies kind of thing. That is called adaptation. Now beaks, I'll tell you. Mouth of birds is called as beaks. They use their beaks to eat. The shape of beaks depends upon the type of food they eat. They also use beaks to build nests. They clean and smoothen their feathers with their beaks. It is called as preening. Is it fine? I'll go to the next slide.
Ma'am, birds do not have teeth.
Okay. Beaks. Wait. In beaks, there are few more. Yeah, they are classified into few more things. I'll tell you. Strong, short, and hard. What kind of beaks? Can you see this picture? I'll tell you.
I don't.
Birds like sparrows, pigeons eat nuts and seeds. Okay, they feed upon nuts and seeds. They need strong beak to crack open their food, so they have strong, short, and hard beaks.
Ma'am, I don't see picture.
This one?
No, now I am see. Now I am see.
I'm seeing which picture?
Now I am seeing.
Which bird now is this?
Sparrow.
Did you see sparrow? It's very short.
Yes.
At the same time, it is very hard. and strong also, because they eat grains and all those seeds, right? Those seeds obviously will not be soft and very smooth. It will be hard. So for them to, you know, they can't eat the, if so much of big seed is there, they can't eat the whole seed like that. You know? So they have to break that seeds into small, small things, and they have to eat one by one. That's why they have very short, hard and strong, small beak. Can you see this thing? Pigeon's beak?
Pigeon.
Yeah. This one? Eastern yellow is robin's beak. Look at this beak. Are you able to see this beak?
Yes. Excuse me, ma'am.
Yeah.
Who was this he? It who was bird?
Strong,
what
sharp.
This bird?
Eagles, vultures, and hawks eat flesh of other birds and animals. So the beaks are strong, sharp, and hooked. They are called birds of prey. Okay.
Birds yeah. of.
You can see this prey. Prey means food. Like you know. The food which vultures and eagles eat.
They are scavengers.
A bird can also become a prey. Yeah.
They are.
Can you see the beak?
Watch her beak.
The voice is breaking, ma. Can you see the beak? Vulture's beak here.
Yes, ma'am. Yes. Yes.
Yes. Look at that. How it is hooked. It is hooked, right? It's called hooked, yeah. Eagles, vulture, hawks, these birds and all will eat the flesh of other animals. And that's why their beaks are like that. You know, there are. That's how. Next thing is. Hawks.
Who is this bird?
Hawk's beak. Can you see this beak?
This bird? Hawk's beak. Hawk's beak.
This is.
Eagle beak.
Eagle and hawk are almost same.
Yeah. Strong chisel shape. I'll tell you what. Eagles
and hawks are just a small motion of eagle.
Can you please see this and read this out? Woodpeckers. Can you see this bird?
What?
Woodpecker's beak.
Yes, woodpecker.
How was it looking? Strong, chisel shaped. I'll tell you, chisel shaped means this is how straight something which is helped to poke. See, what does woodpecker do?
It pecks the wood.
What does it do? Why does it peck the wood? It does it. And another thing is, why does it do it? There will be few worms. Okay. In the tree trunk, we can find worms in it.
No, ma'am.
Hello?
Hello, ma'am.
Yeah.
Hello.
Yes, yes.
Ma'am, this is why not. I think he make for our house. He make a hole for our house.
No. You're seeing cartoons and then telling me no. It's not for that use. But
I see that.
Yeah, woodpeckers do that.
Actually,
the main reason for that is, you know, there will be worms. Worms will be there in the trunk of the tree. Okay, so to pick that worms, few insects, it will have such chisel-shaped beak. I'll tell you. Wait. Look at this. Hoopoe's beak. Hoopoe's beak. Have you seen it? This is woodpecker's beak again.
Woodpecker's beak is very big.
Broad and flat.
It's very big.
Yeah. Ducks eat fishes and insects
and
from muddy
body water.
So they have got
so they
claws and have
got good and big breasts with holes on either side. The
muddy
water flows through the deep holes.
So they have got broad and flat beaks with holes.
Ishan?
Yes.
Ishan Mahesh. Can you please sit in the class instead of sleeping?
This is duck.
Yeah.
This is duck.
Okay. Duck's beak.
I.
Why do they have
duck's
two holes?
Flat and.
I've mentioned it here.
To take the oxygen. To take oxygen.
I'll tell you why. See,
take
these kind of birds, where do they stay? See, they always feed upon fishes and something aquatic animals, okay? So when they feed on that, fishes obviously will be in mud water, right? Sometimes when they get inside on all those things, when they pick up this fish that way, even the mud gets into that their mouth. So for that mud to come out, these holes are helpful for that. Okay, they have very big holes. No? Holes are present even on other birds. This thing also that's are useful to respiration, but this are a little bit broader and bigger because that mud has to come out of that. Goose beak,
green beak. Green have very big beak,
long beak. And pointed.
Yes,
hummingbirds. Sunbirds eat the nectar from the flowers, so they have long pointed beaks.
Hummingbird is very small.
Very small. I think 4 centimeter or something. I guess.
He's big.
Very small bird is this. Yeah, very small. This much only, I feel. Yeah, I guess only so much flower. So it has a
it
very long flower and
pointed. It take a flower juice. For
yeah,
it.
Nectar from the flowers. That's how it is. This hummingbird.
Who's this sunbird? Oh.
Mm.
Ma'am? Excuse me, ma'am.
Okay. Now let's go to the feet.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes, Divya.
Hummingbird is also fly forwards. Hummingbird also fly forwards.
Hummingbird also flies forward and backward also.
Yes.
Yeah.
I only say this.
Yes, yes. Very good. So now let's go into this topic called feet. Birds have 2 feet. They have 4 toes for walking, hopping, picking things, catching and holding food. Different birds have different types of feet. So let's go into that. Can you see these?
Yes. Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Yeah. This is parrot's feet, crow's feet. Sparrow's feet.
And how many?
Repeating bird feet. I'll tell you what it means. Birds like pigeons, sparrows, crows, and parrots preaches on or sits on tree branches. Okay? So when they sit on it, they need grip, no? To sit?
Yes.
They need so they have feet that help them to grip thin or thick branches easily. Right? Next. They have 4 toes, 3 face towards forward and the 4th face is backward. They can move each toe independently. Okay? Next. Talon's feet. Have you seen eagle's feet, hawk's feet, vulture's feet? What do? They just like that grab and then they go. Eat or hunt other animals. They need sharp hooked claws to catch their prey. These sharp hooked claws are called as talons. Okay? Understood, everyone?
Yes.
You have seen, no? You have seen the videos of eagles and vultures, you know, they come, they grab the prey and then they go. And that's why those feet are used for that. next hint feet, I'll tell you what is it. Trowel feet. Trowel is actually a tool which is used to dig the ground. And that's how they got the name trowel feet. I'll tell you, I think it's mentioned over here. Hens toasters need to scratch ground to take out the worms and seeds. You have seen your hens roasters, hen feet. What they do to feed and all, they scratch the grounds, they get worms, they eat. Right?
Yes. And trowel is
used to digging, and that's how they got that trowel feet. Next, hen's feet work like trowels when they scratch the mud. You've seen, no? Here. This feet. That's how they scratch. They get the prey. Yeah.
Next, I see third picture.
Yeah. Climbing birds' feet.
Climbing birds.
Birds like woodpeckers climb the trees and needs to hold on the trees. They have two sharp claws pointing on each direction on their each foot. It helps them to hold trees and balance while they tap on the tree trunk. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Understood?
Okay.
Climbing.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Next is webbed foot. Webbed feet or foot. Yeah. It'll be like webbed. Can you see the duck's feet over here? You can see the webbed. Yeah. Why is it like that? Because they usually live, most of the time they spend on water, in the water only, no? So they'll obviously have to swim. If they want want to swim and all, they can't swim with the normal feet and all. So they'll have this webbed. They're joined with the skin. That's why their feet appears flat. Such feet are called webbed feet. Webbed feet work like paddles and help these in swimming. Wading bird's feet. Can you see the long well of feet? Stork.
Yes.
Their legs also are very long. Stork's feet also is like this. Okay, I'll tell you. Herons and storks are wading birds who can walk in shallow waters. They have long, slender legs with spread out toes. These spread toes help them walk in water easily while catching birds. Next, sounds of the birds. Birds do not have teeth. They have a tongue which helps them to make sound. Okay? Birds use special sounds to call their mates. Mate in the sense, genders. If this is a female, it makes a different sound to call its opposite sex the same bird. Okay? We can identify bird from its call. Parrot is a special bird who can copy human sounds and almost speak like us.
Yeah.
Yeah? Myna, skylark, cuckoo, nightingale. All these are the birds which can, make sounds, different sounds. You can hear this, no? You heard in the early mornings. It's beautiful to hear this and all. Yeah. Next, different birds. Okay, stop making that sounds now. Myna, cuckoo, skylark, and nightingale have sweet sounds. Next is next. Home of birth is called as nest. Birds make their nest. Birds
the eggs raise their young ones.
Yeah, home of birth is called as nest. Birds make their nest to lay eggs and raise their young ones.
A bird baby is
called a chick.
Is called it
stays in the nest till they get old enough to fly. Then they leave and fly. Okay? Birds use straws, fiber, wool, cotton, thread, twigs, leaves, and even paper to build their nest.
Even fly.
Yeah. Can you see this?
Even paper to build their nest.
Can you see this nest?
Yes, Mama.
Yeah, this is how they pick each and every stalk, let it be cotton or fiber or anything. They pick, bring everything, they put it together and they make their nest.
It's like a, like a glass.
This is a weaver's nest. This is crow's nest, a hen sitting on its egg.
nest.
Mother bird lays eggs in the nest. Then they take care of the eggs and keep them warm till they get ready to hatch. Different birds build different types of nests. Now let us come to migration. Someone asked me what is migration. Sonam. Soham. Soham, I'm sorry. Yeah, you can learn about what is migration over here. When the weather of a place becomes unsuitable for the
Of a place becomes unsuitable for birds, they fly away to
other places. They come back when the weather changes again. This process is called migration.
This process is called migration. And birds are called migratory birds.
Migratory birds. Good. So I'll tell you what it is. There are few birds. See, they will be living in one special area. Okay, suppose they that area, let's say that the temperature in that area gets down too much, like it becomes very cold for them, and the birds cannot bear that temperature. In that case, birds from there comes to some other place and lives over there for months until the weather in their place gets changed. I'll say, in winter, when it's very cold in Siberia, Siberian cranes fly to India. Then they go back when it's warm in Siberia. The longest distance migration is done by Arctic tern. They fly from Arctic, that is northern polar region, to Antarctic. These birds, Siberian crane, Arctic tern, European turtle dove, these birds and all, in their place, when it gets chill in their place, all those birds will migrate to India. So once the weather is set over there, they go back to their places. That's it. Okay. So today's class is done. But we'll have to go through the last previous year's question bank. Give me a second.
She had curly hair. No curly. Example.
Ma'am.
Yes. So.
Come, I am down.
Yes. Give me a second. I'll tell you.
Okay. Ma'am, I have a doubt on the assignment.
Assignment doubts, I'll clear. Give me a second for it, okay?
Come, I am down.
Wait.
I am out on bird.
Give me a second. I'll open the previous year's question paper. We'll go through it, okay?
When's a Siberian crane, Arctic tern, European turtle dove? Migration.
Yeah. Are you able to see this?
Yes.
Now I'll be going to each question. You'll have to answer me this, okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. These pictures can be put in order to tell a story. Which of these pictures is most likely to come last? Tell me.
D.
No, wrong.
D.
B. Wait.
C, ma'am. C.
Oh, okay. D. That's correct. Next. Which sense is used to tell if there is sugar in glass of tea?
Taste.
Good.
Taste.
Which of these is an example of liquid water? Ice,
rain.
Rain. Which of these does the most harm to the air?
Picking colorful wildflowers along the highway,
Collecting fallen leaves, chopping down trees.
Chopping trees with an axe in the backyard is the right answer.
Yeah, yeah. Good. Next, which of the following seasons shows the day when the thermometer was left outside?
When this thermometer was left outside.
Yeah.
Which one? It's almost winter.
Summer.
Yeah. Winter.
It almost should be autumn.
Which shows the day, summer. Okay. Which diagram shows back and forth motion? Back and forth motion. Can you see the C diagram?
Yes.
C, option C diagram.
Back and forth motion.
Yeah, that is called as back and forth motion. Next, the pictures compare sizes of four different. What?
Compare the size of four different birds.
How do you arrange the birds in order from smallest to largest? Tell me soon.
Sparrow is the smallest.
Sparrow. Gardener.
Dove crow.
Option, you have to tell. Which option?
Dove crow.
Option?
Sparrow. Quenda.
Demon.
Dove.
Arrow.
Crow.
Arrow. Option D. Sparrow, cardinal, dove, and then crow. Option D.
Okay.
What is answer of 20 and 21?
Energy.
20 is summer. 21 is sea. 20 is summer.
This diagram shows back and forth motion.
Yes. Next, a dog gets the energy it needs to run from. From what will it get its energy?
Water, the sun, the air.
Food.
Food.
Good. The three plants given in the table is grouped together because all the three, I'll tell you, red barberry, full sun, loses leaves, shrub, has trunks. Red maple, part shade, loses leaves, tree, has no trunks. Snowball flower, full sun, loses leaves, shrub, has no trunks. Tell me which is common in these three? All the three loses leaves, right? Which is common?
Common means so what?
Common means same. Which is common in this thing? Full leaves is common in... loses leaves is common in all the three. Red barberry also loses its leaves. Red maple also loses its leaves. Snowball flower also loses its leaves. And that's why it is grouped. So the answer is B. Okay? Yeah. Which of these belong to the center? Tell me. Fur, scales, skin, feathers. Which comes in the center? I'll tell you, read all the options. Things that cover animal's body. Things that helps animal body to get oxygen. Things that make the animal smaller. Things that keep animal's body cool. None of these. Which is option? Good. Now tell me, this sunflower is how many blocks tall? How many? Count these blocks and tell me how many blocks tall is this.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
So answer is?
Nine.
What will happen to the water in the pot if it is left over the campfire? So there is a fire over here and there's water over here. So the fire is all set.
The water turns into ashes.
Like that only.
The water turns into ashes.
No, the water will never turn into ashes. The water will always take a form of gas. It evaporates.
It evaporates, yeah.
When
it
gets so, evaporation is nothing but gas.
Ashes is also gas. Ashes is also gas, no?
No. Ashes. What will happen to the water, they asked. Water is a liquid. So on boiling liquid, it will always turn into gas. Yeah. Which of these weather conditions caused the cornfield to look as shown in the picture? See here. Can you see the picture over here? What size? Do you look at this corn? How is it looking? All the leaves are all down, no, towards the ground.
Yeah.
Why is it like that? What is it making the corn look like?
Drought.
Yeah. Option Very C. Good. Drought. Option C. Okay, good.
It's too
when
hot.
You sharpen a pencil, it becomes. Happens when you sharpen a pencil?
More flexible, smaller, harder, smoother, or no, no, these.
Smaller. It becomes smaller, no? When you sharpen a pencil.
It becomes more the size more small.
Which group of weights has mass of 32 grams? If 32 grams, which mass of the weight has 32 grams? We'll have to count all these things. So 10 plus 10 is 20. 20 plus 5 is 25. 25 plus 1 is 26. 26 plus 1 is 27. So A is not the option. Same way, you have to count all these things. Now tell me which is the option.
B
is the answer. A is not the answer. A counts only till 27. Right?
Oh, sorry.
If you could examine a piece of cloth with hand lens, you would see the cloth is made of.
Examine me. What is this?
If you examine a piece of cloth, you have a piece of cloth. Okay, with hand lens. That means you're looking at it with with your hand lens. You have lens, right? Normal lens. If you look into it. If you look into the cloth, what basically you find? Do you find energy or do you find threads? Do you find glue or minerals?
Threads.
Yes, that is the answer. Correct.
Water boils at 100 degrees Celsius.
Water boils at 100 degrees Celsius. Which thermometer is showing the temperature of the boiling water? Which thermometer here shows 100 degrees Celsius? This shows 70. This shows 100. Next thing. The magnet pick up the nail but not the penny because the nail. Nail and penny.
Because the nail contains iron.
Lighter than penny as a rust on it has sharp point on a pin. Why does good A? It contains just because the name contains iron. It
contains iron.
Yeah. Which object shown below belongs to box B? Box B is this. Okay. Which
B
belongs to this. Why? In B, if you just notice, every object in the B is having a blunt ending. But in box A, every object is having a sharp ending. That's why B is the answer. Next, which block will finish the pattern? Which block will finish the pattern? Let's see.
Blue, green, red, green, red.
Which of these is non-living thing that mice needs to live?
Water, rock, grass, seed, none of these. Water.
Yes. Which of these animals should be in a group that has six legs and only two wings? Look at this, it has six legs and two wings. Good. Next. Which instrument should be used to measure how hot the water is in the pan?
Thermometer.
How hot the water pan thermometer. The picture shows a large area and the animals that live there? Which animal has the largest population in this area? Which animal is very populated in this?
Nice. The hawk.
Soon. The hawk. Yeah.
What is small?
It's the hawk. Yeah.
What is small? It is hawk.
Hawk.
Okay.
It's a bird.
Okay. No, it is hawk.
Next. Hawk. Which of the following ways of traveling pollutes the air the least? Riding the bus, riding a car, riding an airplane, riding a bike. Which will pollute
riding
the
air very nice?
Which will pollute
riding an airplane. And riding an airplane.
Huh. Good. Which of these is floating on water but sinking in oil? The marble, the balloon, the paper clip, the ice cube. Floating on water, but it'll sink in the oil. Oil is here. Ice cube is here.
Ice cube. Ice cube.
Very good.
Ice cube.
Next. The weather is part of the daily news. Tracking the weather is almost important for people.
Ma'am, what is this background voice? Please mute all.
Table who?
Let me see how many more questions are there. Few more questions. Okay. Finish off fast, huh? It's already time. The weather is part of the daily news. Tracking the weather is most important for people who
grow crops.
Yeah, okay. Very good. Which animal probably is made this footmark? Look at this footmark and tell me which animal made this. This, or this?
See, correct.
Which of these do the people build to stop flooding? They build these to stop
dams.
Yes, very good. Dance. Which material will not dissolve in water?
And so sand, salt, baking soda,
sugar. Sand. Which will not dissolve in water?
Baking soda.
Sand. Sand will never dissolve in water. Which among these is junk food?
Burger.
A burger. Yeah. What is the amount of water in the jar? Look at the jar. How much amount of water is there here? How much?
51 ml.
That means you're showing that these all are millimeters.
Milliliters. ML. Do you want
a milliliter here?
See, you have got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. 10 milliliters you have got. Now, this obviously should be in milliliters. Now, you have to tell me if this is 1 milliliter, 2 milliliter, 3 milliliter, 4, 5. So, 5.1 ml is the answer. Okay?
Yes.
Next. Which item can be used over and over again? Tissue, paper cup, glass, milk carton.
Glass.
Milk carton.
Glass. It can be used, you know, over and over again. You can wash that and then use it. Yeah, the picture shows a stick of clay. When the clay is cut into pieces, which of these was the only thing that changed?
It's shape.
Yes, good. Which of these will measure weight?
B.
Which of it's these will measure?
C.
Nancy. C.
That's all done. Yeah, you are done with the assignment. And the previous year paper kept taught it. So yeah, that's it for your class. Okay.
Okay, mom. Bye.
Class. Bye, bye.
Bye,
bye.
Bye.
Have a good day.
Bye.
Bye.
Oh, sorry, sorry. Wait, wait, wait. Hold on, hold on, hold on. Hold on. Someone was asking about the assignment 3. Wait, wait.
Ishan.
No, Ishan is not in. I think Ishan? That is.
Yes, ma'am. I was only asking.
Yeah, yeah. Tell me. Tell me. What is your doubt?
Ma'am, my doubt was... In the hello, in the 16th question of the assignment, it is written that in the 16th question of the assignment, it's written that consider these two statements and choose the correct option. Statement 1 is the main function of Gandhi Jayanti is held at Rajghat. Statement 2 is Guru Parvas is celebrated on the birthday of 10 Sikh Gurus. Ma'am, in the answers, it is written as B, statement 1 is false and statement 2 is true. But ma'am, the main function of Gandhi Jayanti is held at Rajghat in the Google.
Is it given in B? Is it given B in the answers?
Yeah.
Okay, when the right answer is C. C is true. Both the statements are true. Okay, okay. Might be that is a thing you need to change. The answer, I'll edit that answers and I'll send you back. Okay? C okay, is ma'am. Answer.
Bye, ma'am.
Okay? Yeah. Any other okay, doubts? Ma'am.
Thank you.
Bye, ma'am. Have a okay. good day, ma'am.
Bye, ma'am.
Good day, ma'am.
Bye.
Evening, ma'am. Yeah,
have a good day, ma'am. Have a good day.
You too. Bye, bye.